to be a weekly forecast for all signs. So yeah, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. Okay, subscribe to my channel, like this video, and feel free to follow me on social media. All I really have is Instagram right now, so follow me on Instagram. All right, so let's see what spirit has in store for us this week. Okay, we have card number 16, caught in the ruins. All right. So it says, in the ruins of a medieval castle, there's an old person. The bars are still intact. Oh, old prison, my bad. The bars are still intact, but there's no roof over the room, and vines grow over the stones. A man and woman are inside, seating on old stools. A beautiful green forest grows to the left, while the castle ruins extend to the right. This card shows a dark or difficult situation that seems to have you trapped. It could be a hurtful, empty relationship, an unhappy or unsatisfying job, a behavioral or actual addiction, or even negative sabotaging belief system. It's held you captive for some time and may have even begun in some past life. Okay, I'm sorry guys. It says, but there's a way out, as there always has been. It just takes some effort and determination on your part. Even if these limiting situations and actions are strong, they're self-imposed. The courage and strength required to change lie within you. You must change each faulty belief and every sabotaging choice as they happen. If you do nothing, you'll perpetuate your attachment to this dark situation. Like the crumbling castle, negative choices could stand for a long time to come. Don't let the ruins of your past ruin your future. You have the power to climb out now. So what I'm getting from this energy is that this week, you guys need to, there's like a situation that needs to be gotten out of. So it's like putting the work into getting out of a situation or breaking a habit, breaking an addiction. All right, let's see what the Syrian Star Seeds Tarot is talking about. Let's see what this means for us this week. We have the Queen of Cups, Knight of Wands, and the Four of Wands. See, that's that house we're talking about by the castle. This is the castle. This is like the castle in ruins. So I'm getting rebuilding energy. I'm getting you guys. It's like you guys need to fill some type of cup, like your own emotional needs, fulfill your emotional needs. Okay, take action on the things that you wanna go forward in. Okay, some of you guys, I feel like you might want a new home or something like that. I see movement, I do see partnership. Okay, I see something being built up, but you guys need to put in that action, okay? Put forth the effort. Let's see what the Queen of Cups is talking about. We have the Page of Cups. So yeah, if this means learning a new skill, learn a new skill. Okay, I'm also getting downloads. Now we have the King of Cups. Ooh. All right, what else? Four of Pentacles. So this is all about stabilizing emotions. Coming into a place of equilibrium and stability here. I'm seeing meditation, going within as well, stabilizing whatever is inside of yourself internally, so that you can see that on the external. Okay, we have the shadow, which is the devil. So this is looking at certain, like what this is talking about, obsessions, addictions, right? And how it has, what effect it has on your emotional health. Okay, we have the Nine of Wands. So I'm getting that if it's fears, right, if it's like this negative thinking that some of you guys have about like what you deserve and what you can have or what you can manifest, it's blocked you energetically and probably even physically. All right, we have the Justice card. So I'm getting that things will be balancing out here. Okay, I'm getting also karma. So this was talking about past life. So this could be past life karmic energy that you're dealing with here. Okay, that needs to be broken out of. All right, let's see what the Knight of Wands is talking about. The Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, so I see like steady progression. Okay, we have the Knight of Swords, or the Page of Swords, I'm sorry. So yeah, this is about either doing research, studying a bit more, okay? Looking at the details, looking at the fine print. Maybe looking a little deeper into something here. Learning something. We have the King of Pentacles. So that you can master something here, and whatever this is gonna help you get to where you want to go. Like, this is gonna help you like get the money, get the resources. I'm getting like paperwork. I'm getting paperwork or something to help you, like maybe even a cheat sheet or something. Okay, we have the World card. So this is coming out of a cycle here. You guys are definitely ending a cycle because of the work and effort, and it's like groundwork that you put in. Eight of Cups. So yeah, this is walking away from a cycle here, moving away from a cycle, breaking away from something or someone. Yes, yes. Six of Swords, moving away. Okay, some of this energy could even be a physical move. So some of you guys might be wanting to physically move, or this just is a physical move that you guys will be having, okay? Or this is what spirit wants you to do. Okay, you've ended a cycle here, and now it's time to move on. It's time to move on into the life that you wanted. Put forth the action, and it may have came slow because there were still some things that you needed to look over, go over, spirit needed to look over and go over with you before you can move on to the next level. Okay, we have the Ten of Wands. With that, we have the Ace of Wands. So yeah, I'm most definitely getting a new beginning here, and it's gonna take some work. All right, it's gonna take a little bit of effort here, maybe even courage, all right, in order to start something new. What's the Five of Cups with the Four of Wands? So some of you guys might have to leave something or someone or people behind. Okay. We have the Queen of Wands. I wanted to say, don't fret, my pet, because everything is going to be fine. Knight of Cups. And it's like, you guys need to believe that. Okay, I see a lot of like people that want to run their own business or do their own thing. Now's the time to do that, okay? Now is the time. I'm seeing not to procrastinate any longer. You guys are getting offers here. Eight of Pentacles, some of you guys could be getting job offers this week, right? Something that's gonna help you get out of a spot that you've been in. Maybe even picking up more hours for some of you guys at work here. Someone's offering you something more, something that'll help you, okay? Something that'll help you take care of yourself. We have the Two of Cups, okay? So this is like, I'm getting being a team player. This is also like working with somebody. This could be a partnership here. Somebody could be offering you partnership this week. Okay, for others of you, this is about getting out of like a bad relationship, and you guys are going into a new relationship, and this person is like offering you themselves emotionally. Some of you guys may be stuck on the past, but spirit is saying to tighten up. Okay, you guys look good. You guys are attractive people that deserve better than what you had in the past. Okay, that's just what I'm getting. Some of you guys could have had very self-sabotaging beliefs. I'm getting lack mentality, all right? But we have a change here this week, the Death card. Transformation, Four of Cups. Okay, Ten of Pentacles. Okay, for me, this is about prayers coming true, okay? You guys may not see something happening, but it's happening. Maybe you guys didn't see what this person had to offer, but now you guys are understanding this week what this person has to offer. We have the Seven of Cups. So these are, I feel many doors opening, okay? We have the Five of Pentacles. I'm getting that this energy is going to get you out of poverty. Yeah, Three of Wands. You guys have a path that's open to you now. There's something open to you now that's going to help you get out of poverty, but it's like, why did I hear get your head out of your ass? But basically, it's like there's so many resources around you. Just look around you, because this person is looking up and they're not paying attention. And I'm getting that, yes, there's a lot changing this week, all right? There's a lot changing here, all right? And yeah, some of you guys could be getting over like depressive energy and coming into more abundant energy. This could be familial as well, maybe inherited, something inherited, maybe depression. Okay. Yeah, but I'm seeing like many doors opening, like avenues of resources, ways to get money. Okay. At the bottom of the deck, we have the Fool. So this is starting something new, taking a leap of faith, okay? Take that leap of faith to get out of this, because all of this is really in your head. Okay, let's see what the Angels of Atlantis have to say. I'm seeing a lot of like bandages. So it's like being repaired. It's like something about your energy is being repaired or something. I'm getting a repair, maybe DNA repair. Your DNA is coming back together, or like, I'm getting something like that, like 10-10 energy. Did we get, yeah, we did. We got the Ten of Wands and the Ten of Pentacles, so yeah. I am getting things balancing out this week for the better. So let us see what the Angels of Atlantis have to say. Yeah, yeah. All right, so we have joy. So I feel like whatever is going on this week, you guys need to feel the feelings of joy in order to manifest whatever it is that you're wanting, or just be in that energy. You know what I'm saying? Just be in that energy of joy, and just know that there's better out there, and that everything that you imagine or perceive to be an obstacle, it's really not an obstacle. Like, there's no lock on this door. Like, you guys can get out of it if you really wanted to, is what I'm getting. And then we have balance again. Here we go. So like I said, everything's coming into balance, okay? Things are evening out. The scales are weighing the way they're supposed to weigh, okay? Everything's just balancing out for you, all right? And then we have Archangel Uriel, abundance. So most definitely, I do see, like, once you get out of this mindset, once you get out of this energy, right, and you get into the energy of joy, bliss, and everything that comes with this energy right here, I'm getting solar plexus energy as well. That's the energy of abundance. And it's like, well, abundance of what? Abundance of whatever it is that you want, right? So once you're in the energy of joy, then that's where you can manifest. That's where you find the equilibrium within yourself to get what it is that you're trying to get, to be able to be so like chill and calm to get these like downloads and messages that you're needing to get. Also like steps, I'm getting steps, getting the steps that you need to move forward with something or someone or whatever the situation may be for you, right? Okay, so let's go with the Oracle of the Shadows and Light. We have card number 42, Ghosts of the Past. The past returns for a time. So let's see what that's about. See, I keep getting like past life energy. Oh, we are in Mercury, pre-Mercury, why can't I say stuff right now? Pre-Mercury retrograde energy. Damn, that was a mouthful. If you guys lasted this long, put some grapes in the comment section down below so I know it's real. All right, Ghosts of the Past divination message. It says old friends, boyfriends, crushes, places and situations, or reminders of them come up to remind you of either how far you've come or that there's still work to be done in areas you thought were long settled. We all have life themes and we all have challenges and patterns. But the trick is to move through them quickly and to learn from them permanently. These ghosts with masks are here to show you what or who needs an adjustment in your life. A clearing where you make peace with people you feel you may have wronged is in order. None of us is perfect. All of us need to forgive and to be forgiven. This is the cause of the indecision you're now facing. The ghosts of the past are haunting you. It's judgment day and you're more powerful than you know. The time for hiding who you are and pretending to be normal and just like everyone else is done. I'm getting karma, karmic justice, karmic balance. Maybe some of you guys were attached to a karmic or somebody with very lower vibrational energies. Maybe somebody that was emotionally neglectful or childish. Okay. Maybe that's who you're dealing with this week or who you have dealt with. Okay. But the thing is, you need to balance out your own. The shadow work needs to be done, right? Is what I'm getting on the pain that this person may have caused you, because they're getting their karma. You know what I'm saying? They're reaping what they sow. But whatever they said or did to you, it has nothing to do with you, is what I'm getting. Some of you guys may have had to pretend to be somebody that you're not in order to fit in with this people or this person or this situation here. but I'm also getting that you guys took action to stop that, and it may have taken some time to step out of this energy here. Maybe some of you guys went into counseling, or you're reading self-help books, watching self-help videos. Okay, with the King of Pentacles, yeah, this is really mastering yourself, mastering certain things on this earthly realm. And with the World card, this is stepping out of a cycle because you've learned a lesson and it's time to walk away. And I'm getting that you guys did walk away or are walking away. You're taking the steps that are needed. Yes, it may be hard, but I'm seeing fruit being born or something like that, or something bearing fruit. All right, starting a new beginning, having the internal flame, the fire to seek balance within your life, okay? This is understanding that you deserve abundance of happiness, joy, money, health. Okay, I see some of y'all's health was declining. Yeah, some of y'all's health was declining. Let me read She Speaks. It says, all about me are ghosts of the past. Come here, perhaps, so I can finally lay them to rest. I've taken off my mask and know who I am, while they're still wearing theirs and still very much as I left them so long ago. It seems I must turn and face them to make peace with them, perhaps even going over some old ground before I can move on to fresh fields. I have an urge to put my mask on and mingle with them as I was, but I will not. I'll be who I am now and meet them without pretense and show them who I have become. I'm no longer afraid of the shadows in my past. We got the shadow card. I'm at peace with all I've been and all that I am. So you guys might need to do some shadow work, okay? Do some shadow work to get yourself out of a situation here. Maybe heal something here. What chakras am I getting? I am getting solar plexus. She's wearing green. Definitely heart chakra, throat chakra, speaking your truth. Third and crown chakra. This is understanding that you are connected to the most divine, right? Or connected. Did I say the most divine? I meant the most high. You're connected to the Most High, connected to the Divine. You know what I mean. You know what I mean. Yeah, at the bottom of the deck, it says, Storm Angel, collision of beliefs, cycles, attitudes, or styles, attitudes, and energies. So, that might be a thing for you guys too. Maybe some of your beliefs clash with certain people, and some of you guys want to hide yourselves, and it's, they're saying not to hide yourself, just be you. They can wear the mask, but where the wealth is in your authenticity. All right, so let's pull from the Sacred Self-Care Oracle. Let's see how you guys can take care of yourselves this week. So you guys have card number 35, meditate. You have card number 46, soak in a bath. And you have card number 23, family. Yeah. Yeah. So I am definitely getting some Virgo energy here, especially with the Archangel Gabriel. Mercurial energy. This is tapping in, getting information from the Most High. Okay. Connecting back to self and growing spiritually. Yeah, and then we have soak in a bath. So some of you guys might want to take a spiritual bath this week, or even a spiritual shower, you know, just meditate in the shower as well, is what I'm getting. And then you guys have family, so this could be another thing that you guys might feel like you're stuck in. All right, you might be stuck, you might feel like you're stuck in a family situation, but also I'm getting it's like, let your family help you, or like, you guys have like soul family here, okay? Yeah. For some of you guys, it could be either one of those situations here with family. Either you feel like you're stuck in a family situation here, or there's something about like family helping you. I'm also getting generational problems, or something being, like I said earlier, something being passed down generationally. It's something familial, okay? At the bottom of the deck, we have deep breathing. So yeah, meditate and breathe deep. All right. I'm also getting like intuition, something about intuition being passed down. Someone passed something down to you. Let's see what the goddesses have to say. And then we'll pack it up. No, we'll pull one more and then we'll pack it up because the sun is going down already. Already. Mm-hmm. All right, we have Cordelia, go outside. You've been indoors too long, go outside and get some fresh air. So that's what I'm getting also from this, is like enjoy nature, maybe go on a walk, all right? But get outside. Yeah, it's quarantine, but outside and closed. All right, so we have Unag, easy does it. There's no need to hurry or force things to happen. Everything's occurring in perfect timing. So some of you guys may want to get out of situation like yesterday, but just chill, everything's going the way it's supposed to. Plans are unfolding perfectly, is what I'm getting, okay? So we have Hathor receptivity, allow yourself to receive. This will increase your intuition. What did I say about something about intuition being passed down? This will increase your intuition, energy, and ability to give to others, okay? So just be open to something here. This may have something to do with family. Alright, I keep getting that. I'm getting like karmic family, something like that. Alright, and at the bottom of the deck, we have bold, unleash your adventure side, take risks, and be daring. This is that energy of being different, being the black sheep, maybe. Maybe some of you guys were considered the black sheep or are considered the black sheep right now, okay? But it's because you're meant to do bigger things, you're different, and you're meant to be different. And that's just what it is. So I'm pulling from the Let Go Oracle. I see what we should let go of this week. I think I'm gonna pull three of these. She says, control your emotions, feel them, shift them, elevate them, be a master. We talked about the master, right? Mastering something here, mastering your, we got the King and the Queen of Cups and the Page of Cups. So yeah, all right, so hone in those emotions. Yes, I'm getting emotionally charged energies, but it's like taking back control of that, right? Okay, so we have this lady right here painting. She said, we couldn't know paradise if flowers refused to release their fragrance. Give your gifts freely. So this is, I'm getting this energy of like just doing you, being in your flow, okay? focusing on your craft. Focusing on your craft. Sharing your gift. And then we have this lady right here. Looking all seductive. She said, don't compare yourself to others. Smile and be content with your natural beauty. Well, that's nice. So I'm getting, don't mask yourself. Maybe wear less makeup. Be more natural. Okay. Wear less makeup. Why did I get wear less makeup? Okay, wear less makeup. Yeah. Wear your natural hair. Like, try not to put on nails. I don't know why I'm getting this, but I'm getting this. Just be yourself. I'm getting be you. Just be you. Take off the mask. Everything that you used as a crutch, take it off. Or take one thing off. You don't have to take it all off. Just go without it this week. Okay. That's all I got for y'all. Love y'all. And I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.